Hi guys, hope you guys are doing well during this circuit breaker period. Okay, today, no more funny videos, okay? Today we are going to talk about, tenya fishing with you guys. So as you guys know, tenya fishing is getting popular nowadays in Singapore. Okay, I'm going to share my my experience with you guys during tenya fishing in Singapore, okay? Okay, there's a few parts we're going to go through. The rod, the reel, the tenya, okay, and how to do tenya fishing, okay? So tenya fishing, I think, started out in Japan, okay? Where it's just like a tenya like this. They hook on a prawn and they drop, okay? So it's just like a traditional Hong Kong hook. Okay, so I mean, technology always advanced. Keep on going, getting better. So yeah, this is tenya fishing. So so let's start with the rod that I'm using, okay? I'm using a big caster Shimano X-Tune, okay? Then the reel I'm using Ocean Conquest 301HG. Tenyas, Hums Cha-Cha, Daiwa. So before I go on further, okay, this video is not a sponsored video and I'm not affiliated with any like tackle shops or any brands, okay? Well, so yeah, this one, that's gonna start, okay? So tenya rod, they have a very special characteristics. You will realize that most of the tenya rods built by reputable brand, okay, like Shimano, Daiwa, Graphite Leader, and some other brand, okay? So they have this particular portion. This particular portion is to actually cushion the fish and bite. Okay, why? Fish grabs their food by sucking in their food, okay? So when there's any resistance or there's too much resistance, it will tend to throw out the food. Okay, so this is where it comes in place. So technically, with this tip, it cushions. So the fish doesn't feel any resistance, so you will get a better hookup rate, okay? Alright, so yeah, I mean, tenya rods come in different length, usually like 6 feet. Mine is a 8 one, okay? Mine is a 8 feet, yeah? Okay, the reel. Why I choose a high gear reel? Because I would love to retrieve more line when I'm fighting with the fish, okay? Yeah, because sometimes it's too slack and the fish go too fast. Yeah, so I load a P1.2 color braided line. Okay. Well, why color braided line? Because that we know that what depth we are fishing and how deep we are fishing. So most color braided line comes with like one color every 10 meter. So technically, if you are fishing at 20 meter, it should be at 2 colors. Fine. Okay. And the leader that I'm using, size 5. Sometimes size 6 and even size 4. Size 6 depends on the terrain that we are going there. Is it a lot of rock area or not? Yeah. So tenya, okay. Tenya come in various sizes. Initially when I started out tenya, I used to believe that I use very heavy tenya because I need to drop down to the bottom as fast as possible. That's not true, okay? Actually, the lighter tenya you go, the better it is. So, this is called pro fishing, okay? Tenya, one size, you can see that size 3, okay? So, size 3 technically is like 12 gram. Okay, it depends on the maker. So, one size is actually 3.5 or 4 grams, okay? So, usually, when we fish in Singapore, usually I'm using size 8, 10, 12, sometimes 14. Anything heavier than that, I try and defeat the purpose of using tenya. Okay, like those, I see anglers using 80 grams, 100 grams, even the last time I saw one was like 200 grams. I said, why are you using tenya? Well, because it's, you need to touch the ground first. So, no. So, later part, I'm going to show you why you don't need to touch the ground first. Okay, yeah, and how to set up, how to put a prawn into the tenya. Okay, like this. Okay, sorry, no live prana. So we're gonna use this rubber thingy. So technically the legs are facing upwards and the eyes is downwards. Okay, a little bit of advice, don't try to beautify or modify your tenya by putting all those flare or so-called momo thing, okay? It technically has no effect. So it just creates resistance in the water. Okay. Now what I tell you that you need the tenya to slowly sink down to the bottom is like this hand. Yeah. Pardon for my bad drawing. Okay, let's say today you are fishing at a 20 meters depth. Okay. So okay, this is, imagine this way is the tenya and this is the line, okay? So apparently you need the tenya to slowly sink down. Okay, you see the mid-level tenya has fish, that's why you slowly sink down. Whether do you attract them is another thing. So usually tenya we try to go for like bottom feeder. Bottom feeder fish are like, you know, all your guys' favorite angkau, tua kau, malabar, parrotfish, you know, enko, kachi, anything that fits on the bottom, we are called bottom feeder. So you need to go down. Your boat is here, the boat is here, so you drop the line down. So technically you need to maintain this tenya at the hip zone by bouncing it. Okay? Bounce. 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 Always bounce at the hip zone. Okay? This will give you more effective hook coverage. Okay. Why that we don't use very thick PE lines? Because that the thicker the line, the harder for the tenya to sink down to the bottom. Okay, arjing anglers will know this very well, okay, because they really pay very light line and they are able to let the jig head to sink. Okay? So technically you bounce, bounce, bounce until that you find that your line is like, okay, like, imagine you are fishing, okay, let's say on the side. Your line technically should maintain, best to be straight down. A little bit further like this, still okay. Anything that's more than this, you should always retrieve the line back and start putting the drop again already. Okay? Okay, sorry about the thick PE line, right? It says that when the thick PE line and those thick heavy tenya, technically when you start dropping on the bottom, the current pushes, you find that your line barely. Then you find, I feel very deep. Actually, it's not. It's because that the current is pushing and the tenya on the floor is so heavy that then the line barely. So the boat will start drifting. The boat will start drifting, drifting, drifting further away. And you will find that your line is actually here, but your tenya is already very far outside already. So by the time you retrieve back, you're already stuck. And this is why sanko happened. Okay? So yeah. So remember, always keep maintain straight drop a little bit, like 30 degrees, still okay. Anything more than 50-60, you can just retrieve it back already. Okay? Alright? So you guys understand, okay? And one thing, usually when there's pelagic around, if your tenya slowly flutters down, and you find that the line from you start going, not going out anymore, but you say, it's only at 10 meter, which means that the chances that the fish has already taken the tenya already. So this time you just have to retrieve, maintain the tension, feel the mass, and start set it, okay? Don't set it too much, maybe 2 to 3 times is good enough, a good solid one, okay? There's no need to keep on setting the fish. It doesn't make sense. You're just throwing the hook out of the fish mouth. Okay. So how do you normally attach the tenya? You can actually tie the leader direct to the swivel here. If not, usually that what I'm doing that I will have a leader with a swivel and a split ring, okay? Yeah. So everything is going to be very small because it's quite finesse. So why this is useful, sometimes you need to change your tenya. So that's all about tenya fishing in Singapore. Oh, one thing about tenya fishing in Singapore that you really need to get a boatman that knows what he's doing. He knows the depth, the current, the type, and the place that you're fishing in. Okay? Yeah, man. So during this circuit breaker season, I'll try to do more videos on different type of styles of fishing. Okay? Meanwhile, you guys, if anything you want to know more, you can comment below. Yeah, okay. I'll try to reply all of you guys and tell me what we like to watch, what you like to know. Okay, and one more thing before I go. I find that this box, which I got from Daiso, yeah, is really useful. Okay, it actually helped me to clean all my tackle, like tenya. So after fishing, when you come home, you just drop a tenya box and just put in the water. Then you rinse, bring up, then leave it dry. Next day, you can just take out everything and start collecting, putting it back to the tackle box. So, yeah, just a recap. So, yeah, one more important thing. Is it a must to use a tenya setup when you do tenya fishing? The answer is yes and no, okay? Why? Imagine you're a tennis player. Will you take a badminton racket to play tennis? No, right? But you can still do so, but it's not effective. So that goes to the same thing. So to have more effective, to produce more effective catch on tenya, you really need to use the right setup. Okay? So meanwhile, guys, you stay safe, stay healthy, no, stay at home. Don't run around, no, you can do your essential stuff. If it's not essential, just stay at home. And and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.